What do you think?
I think we're in play. The Klitschko piece is obviously the complicated electron here, especially the announcement of him as deputy prime minister. And you've seen some of my notes on the troubles in the marriage right now, so we're trying to get a read really fast on where he is on this stuff. But I think your argument to him, which you'll need to make, I think that's the next phone call we want to set up, is exactly the one you made to Yats. And I'm glad you sort of put him on the spot on where he fits in this scenario. And I'm very glad he said what he said in response.
Good. So I don't think Cleach should go into the government. I don't think it's necessary. I don't think it's a good idea.
Yeah, I mean, I guess you think, what in terms of him not going into the government, just let him sort of stay out and do his political homework and stuff. I'm just thinking in terms of sort of the process moving ahead, we want to keep the moderate Democrats together. The problem is going to be Tanibok and his guys. And, you know, I'm sure that's part of what Yanukovych is calculating on all of this.
I think Yats is the guy who's got the economic experience, the governing experience. He's the guy, you know, what he needs is Cleach and Tanibok on the outside. He needs to be talking to them four times a week, you know. I just think Cleach going in, he's going to be at that level working for Yatsenyuk. It's just not going to work.
Yeah, no, I think that's right. Okay. Good. Well, do you want us to try to set up a call with him as the next step?
My understanding from that call, but you tell me, was that the big three were going into their own meeting and that Yats was going to offer in that context a three-way, you know, the three-plus-one conversation or three-plus-two with you. Is that not how you understood it?
No, I mean, that's what he proposed, but I think just knowing the dynamic that's been with them where Klitschko has been the top dog, he's going to take a while to show up for whatever meeting they've got, and he's probably talking to his guys at this point, so I think you reaching out directly to him helps with the personality management among the three, and it gives you also a chance to move fast on all this stuff and put us behind it before they all sit down and he explains why he doesn't like it.
Okay, good. I'm happy. Why don't you reach out to him and see if he wants to talk before or after?
Okay, will do. Thanks.
Okay, I've now written, one more wrinkle for you, Jeff.
Yeah.
I can't remember if I told you this or if I only told Washington this, that when I talked to Jeff Feltman this morning, he had a new name for the UN guy, Robert Seri. Did I write you that this morning?
Yeah, okay. I saw that.
He's now gotten both Seri and Ban Ki-moon to agree that Seri could come in Monday or Tuesday.
Okay.
So that would be great, I think, to help glue this thing and have the UN help glue it and, you know, fuck the EU.
No, exactly. And I think we've got to do something to make it stick together because you can be pretty sure that if it does start to gain altitude, the Russians will be working behind the scenes to try to torpedo it. And again, the fact that this is out there right now, I'm still trying to figure out in my mind why Yanukovych did that. But in the meantime, there's a Party of Regions faction meeting going on right now, and I'm sure there's a lively argument going on in that group at this point. But anyway, we could land jelly side up on this one if we move fast. So let me work on Klitschko, and if you can just keep, I think we want to try to get somebody with an international personality to come out here and help to midwife this thing. And then the other issue is some kind of outreach to Yanukovych, but we probably regroup on that tomorrow as we see how things start to fall into place.
So on that piece, Jeff, when I wrote the note, Sullivan's come back to me, VFR, saying you need Biden, and I said probably tomorrow for an attaboy and to get the deets to stick. So
okay.
Biden's willing.
Okay, great.
All right.
Thanks.
Is this a round sound in a two-inch wall? I was waiting for the communist call. I didn't ask for sunshine and I got World War III. I'm looking over the wall and now look at me. Now I got a reason, now I got a reason. Now I got a reason and I'm still waiting. Now I got a reason, now I got a reason to be waiting. The Berlin Wall.
Your fight is our fight.
Ваша боротьба – це наша боротьба.
2017 will be the year of offense.
Рік, 2017 рік буде ріком нападу.
All of us will go back to Washington and we will push the case against Russia.
Ми всі повернемося до Вашингтону і ми будемо відстоювати санкції проти Росії.
Enough of a Russian aggression.
Досить вже російської агресії.
It is time for them to pay a heavier price.
Час вже, щоб вони заплатили важчу ціну.
I believe you will win. I am convinced you will win, and we will do everything we can to provide you with what you need to win.
Я вірю в те, що ви виграєте, переможете. Я переконаний в тому, що ви переможете, і ми вам допоможемо всіма можливими засобами. Thank you.
Це те саме гільзи з ворожих БМП, які розмальовані художницями.
З Новим роком, дорогі мої!